Narrating his ordeal, Gomba says the whole episode felt like a dream as the crocodile kept on charging at him.
It was like a dream at first when the crocodile pounced at me, targeting my midsection. I pushed it away with all my strength, but it charged again, this time around with more force. I fell in the water, but I continued to kick at it until I managed to put a distance between myself and the crocodile. While it attacked me, everyone was running for their lives.
Gomba says their communal tap at Ndama had been without water for days as the Rundu water crisis worsened. He was rushed to the Rundu State Hospital, where he is recovering from his wounds.
We pay $100 per month at our communal tap, but for the past 8 days, we did not have water. That's why we went to fetch water from the river.
The Minister of Environment, Forestry and Tourism spokesperson, Romeo Muyunda, says the crocodile will be put down as it is declared problematic. Muyunda cautioned residents to be vigilant when making use of the river. Thousands of Rundu residents rely on the Kavango River for water, as taps again have been dry for a consecutive fourth day since Wednesday. Meanwhile, NamWater has written to the Rundu Town Council of its decision to ration water supply to the town for a week as of 22 October. NamWater Chief Executive Officer Abraham Nehemiah, in the letter, states that this will allow council to mobilize funds to purchase enough units. Rundu Town Council Chief Executive Officer Olavi Nathanael could not respond to the development as his mobile went unanswered after several attempts. The council initiated Operation Revenue Collection this week, targeting to disconnect at least 10,000 water accounts in arrears and to root out illegal connections. Chris Kopolo, NBC News.